The backdrop for this study is that intimate partner violence is the most prevalent form of violence globally. 1 in 3 women worldwide has experienced physical or sexual abuse from an intimate partner.
And there is some evidence now, there's some promising evidence that shows that cash transfers can reduce intimate partner violence.
Because cash transfer programs usually don't continue indefinitely, in order for us to understand whether they can be a sustainable approach to reducing IPV, we really need to know what happens after they end. Previous studies have not had the data to look at that. We do have that data.
The program, TMRI, was a cash or food transfer program to young mothers. The transfers were with or without BCC, so the behavior change communication. It was weekly meetings of mothers to talk about nutrition and how to feed their young children.
So the headline finding is really that 6 to 10 months after the program, women who had received transfers plus BCC experienced 26% less physical violence from their partners than women who had received nothing in a control group.
There was no impact 6 to 10 months later of just cash.
So transfers alone may not be enough to continue impacts on the things that actually affect IPV after the program is over. We think this really gives a role for policymakers to try to introduce BCC alongside cash transfers and kind of experiment to see what actually works for reducing IPV sustainably.